The administration has approved emergency use authorization for the Johnson & Johnson COVID vaccine. Officials say the vaccine is about 70% effective against severe infection 14 days after receiving the single dose shot. Although these rates are not as high as the vaccines currently on the market with Pfizer and Moderna, the Johnson & Johnson shot only requires one dose. And so we know the other ones require two. Joining us now with more on the latest COVID-19 and vaccine information is Dr. Abisola Alulade of Sharp-Reese-Stiley. Good morning, doctor.
Good to see you, Lori. Good morning.
You too. So a few things to talk to that developed recently. The first one, we'll kind of go off that last story, the fact that the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is now in play. What are your thoughts on both the effectiveness of it and really its effectiveness against the variants too?
So it's really good news. It's exciting news. If they do end up authorizing this on Friday, it is exciting. We got the preliminary briefing documents that were released yesterday, and it shows that it is a safe vaccine. It is effective, and it is really good at preventing you from getting severely ill and hospitalized, which suggests that it's good at preventing you from dying from COVID. So it's really, really good news. And as you said, it's a one-shot vaccine. So that makes it more convenient for a lot of people potentially, and also the storage requirements. It doesn't require the ultra cold freezing temperatures that the Pfizer vaccine requires. So it could be a game changer in terms of improving our supply. And so it's very exciting. And in terms of the variant protection, it actually was protective against the South Africa variant. It was in the 60s in terms of protection, which is really, really good.
Yeah, certainly better than nothing, right? And what do we know with studies of this vaccine about its really effectiveness in transmitting the virus? Is it still sort of unknown with the other ones?
It is. There's some preliminary evidence that it may be protective against that. We need more definitive evidence, and there's not yet a consensus at this point, but we're seeing a lot of encouraging data coming out even from the UK in terms of the other vaccines. And we saw that when Moderna released their study as well, that there may be protection against transmission and infection. So it is promising, but we still have to wear masks because there's not a consensus yet. It's a bit of a difficult thing to determine that specific protection against infection. So we still need to wear masks, still need to distance, but there's a lot of hope, and this is very optimistic.
And now that it is likely the Johnson & Johnson vaccine will come into play, should people be considering or trying to get one vaccine over another?
Yeah, so this is a really good question, one that I get every single day. And, you know, unfortunately, when you look at those numbers, it can really give the false impression that one vaccine is not as good as the other. And it would be wrong to assume that, because when you look at the numbers, first of all, the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines were tested at a time when presumably there weren't these variants that we're seeing. And with the Johnson & Johnson vaccine, they did test them at times when these variants were dominant and they were high in these regions. And so you can't compare, you can't just look at that number and think that it's less effective. It is still good at protecting against severe illness and hospitalization. And so I would recommend that you get whichever one whenever it's available to you. And they were also measuring different endpoints. So, you know, it's hard to compare those numbers. So they're good vaccines. They're all safe. They're all effective, which is really great news.
And what seems like more great news, the county, citing sort of a slack in interest from the senior community, has decided to open up early, starting Saturday, vaccinations for a large number of people, 500,000 about, including law enforcement officers, teachers, food handlers. Are we going to be getting to a large enough portion of the community to hopefully reach that herd immunity everybody's talking about?
Well, you know, this is a million-dollar question, and we don't know quite yet what the threshold will be. It's just hard to determine what exactly that threshold will be and when we'll get there. Certainly, we know that most people have to be vaccinated, more people than not. So it's hard to say based on what we have, you know, in terms of the distribution. We saw that it has been slow initially. It's getting better. So we just have to wait and see. But it highlights the fact that when it is your turn, you should get vaccinated because it helps all of us reach that endpoint that we really, really desperately want to get to.
And it really does help in us further seeing these mutations. I mean, the news coming out of New York and other portions of the Northeast talking about the B1526 variant is showing a little concern because of its resistance to some antibody therapy.
Well, you know, actually, it's actually a bit preliminary to suggest that. You know, certainly it does have, from what we've seen, characteristics that have been seen in other variants that do show a decrease in terms of response to the neutralizing protection of the vaccines. But the protection that we've seen in the past does not go low enough to render the vaccine ineffective. And these variants that have been found in New York, even here in California, have not been identified as variants of concern yet. A lot of this data that we're seeing is preliminary, hasn't been peer reviewed. So it is troubling if they do pan out to be more contagious, but at this point we have to see more data and remember that we can still continue to do all those things like masking, distancing, taking care of your chronic conditions, exercising, trying to get sleep, taking care of your mental health. All of those things will help in general. So we don't need to panic, but we should prepare.
All right. Well, good news on the vaccine front. Thank you, Dr. Ololade. Appreciate it as always.
Good to see you. Thanks for having me.